The development in semiconductor technology allows us to integrate LEDs into our life, whether it is for decoration, additional lighting under your kitchen cabinet, or even lighting up your backyard.
In the past, it was pretty simple to power up ordinary controls or displays that used LEDs. All you needed was a power supply and current limiting resistor. That's all. But today the requirements for power supplies or semiconductors change significantly.
In this video, we will go through the necessary functions required by the LED driver that will help you to choose the proper one for your application.
Don't forget to subscribe to our channel and like this video. Let's go! The LED driver is not a simple power supply that you might use to charge your phone. This solution is based on the design that from the very beginning has embraced the specific properties of LEDs to ensure their optimal operation, durability, energy efficiency, and protection against damages.
A classic power supply would not be able to provide all of these functionalities. Moreover, different models of drivers may vary significantly, and the differences depend on the target application. For example, home lighting LED drivers are different from stage lighting. One of the first things that you should check is what type of LED driver is required. Is it constant current or constant voltage? The best way to find out which one you need is to read the technical specifications provided by the manufacturers.
If you are using an LED strip where all the LEDs are connected in parallel, you should use constant voltage. On the other hand, if the LEDs are connected in series, you should use a constant current one. To give you a better understanding, let's analyze what might happen if you use the wrong LED driver. Here we have three LEDs that are connected in series. They should use constant current LED driver. This driver will increase the voltage depending on the number of LEDs in the circuit, but will keep the current stable and none of the LEDs will burn.
Just to make it clear, if the current of LEDs will go above the maximum current, the LED will light up very brightly, but only for a very short period of time, and there is no hope. The maximum forward current can be found in the specifications. Usually it is 20 mA or 50 mA for ribbon LEDs.
Okay, so coming back to the CC and CV, the constant voltage LED drivers will keep the voltage at the same level, let's say 12 volts, and will increase the current as the number of LEDs increases. Do you get what happens if you connect the CV power supply to CC LEDs?
If you want more information about linear or switch mode power supplies, you can check our other video. If you have bought an LED light bulb, you must have noticed that unlike incandescent light bulbs, they consume much less power to get to the same luminosity. They are much more efficient. However, all this can go wrong if you use an LED driver that has low efficiency.
Let's take an example from a different world. I have an electric car. Green energy, right? Not so fast. You cannot say that you are more greener just by driving an electric car. The next question should be, where does the electricity to charge it come from?
And then consider the size of the battery and that one day you will need to recycle it.
If most of the electricity comes from renewable resources, then yes, it is green. But if the energy comes from coal, for example, then I think you know the answer. The same applies to our LEDs. Using an inefficient LED driver will cost you more, and the idea to keep this planet green goes to the trash.
If you want an efficient LED driver, search for a switch mode power supply that has an active PFC like those LED drivers from Meanwell.
Visit our website TMEU for more suggestions. And if you want to know more about active power factor correction, let us know down in the comments.
Have you heard about the new technology, LiFi? It's a light communication system that is capable of transmitting data at high speeds over the visible light, ultraviolet and infrared spectrum. So your LED light bulb is kind of a router.
But doesn't it mean it has to flicker to transmit data?
Yeah, but it does in very high frequencies.
Don't you know that flickering lights, especially LEDs or fluorescent, can cause huge health problems? Flickering has been proved to cause headaches, migraines, eye strain and even epilepsy.
However, with quality LED lighting, flickering can be largely removed, so you can consider it flicker-free.
If you care for your health, check the LDC series from Meanwell. Those ensure a low-level pulsation in the first section and a wide margin between the peak voltage and the maximum voltage regulated at the output. This guarantees the operation of the lighting system without flickering.
If you have decided to use an LED strip, you need to pay attention to the voltage. Two common operating voltages are 12 volts and 24 volts. The 24 volt LED strips have some advantages over the 12 volts. However, if you use compatible parts for your installation or if your LED strip is no longer than 10 meters, then there is no big difference.
The 12 volt LED strips have better customization during the installation. Unlike the 24 volt LED strips, they can be cut into segments of 3. The 12 volt LED strips are also more common, like in cars where you have the car battery, which is 12 volt, and you don't need additional converters or equipment to install them.
And from the efficiency point of view, the 24 volt is much better. Only 13% of the power consumption is wasted in comparison to 25% for 12 volts.
It is a good rule of thumb to make sure that the total power consumption of the LED strip is at least 20% less than the power supply capacity. You should never use a power supply that provides the same or less power required by your LED strip.
Here is an example of how to calculate the proper LED driver for your LED strip. Well, we wish to use 3.5 meter long strip. The strip consumes 25 watts per meter. Multiply 3.5 by 25, the total is 87.5 watts. Then we multiply 87.5 by 1.2, which gives us 105 watts.
If the power supply runs at maximum capacity, it will heat up and die out quickly due to wear and tear. Let us know if you need more information about dimming, control protocols, or any other question about LED drivers in the comments below.
If you like this video, hit the like button, subscribe to our channel, and see you next time.
Bye bye.